Hey everyone, and welcome back to a new video. Today we'll be looking at the HHKB Pro 2. This was kindly sent out to me by PFU, the manufacturer, to review, but they haven't told me anything to say about it, and I just really want to test it. So here are my thoughts. Alright, so let's get right into it. So starting with the box, I quickly packaged it up just to show you the unboxing experience. Basically, all that you get is super minimal. I got a USB cord, which is just a standard USB cable in black, and I also got the keyboard. So when you get it new, this comes packaged in some plastic foil, but this has already been unpacked, so you don't get that. And what else is left is some safety information, and that's pretty much all that you get in the box. So taking a look at the keyboard directly, we can see that this is a really unique layout. This is a HHKB layout, which is a 60% form factor, but with a few tweaks, which we'll get into soon. On the sides, it's pretty minimal. We don't have anything on the left and right sides, so as you can see, it's just black. And on the front, it's also empty. The only piece of branding is the little logo in the bottom right corner. And on the back, we have the USB input and two USB-A outputs, which act as a USB hub. These are not any powered hubs, so you can only connect something like a Bluetooth adapter or your mouse, but nothing like a hard drive will run off this. And then looking here further, we see there's a little panel, and opening up this reveals there's some dip switches. And the idea of these dip switches is that you can configure different layouts, which I can show you here. So at the back of the keyboard, we can see there are different configurations that you can make. There's a few changes that can be done. So for example, when you change it to the Mac mode, for example, you have volume control keys and your start menu button actually changes to the control key. So these are really nice tweaks. Now coming back to the layout, you might notice it's missing some spaces here at the bottom corners. And this is because the idea of the HHKB is that it's supposed to be much more ergonomic to type on, since this was made by programmers. So the idea is that at the top you have your control key, which was moved from the bottom right here to the top, and this replaces the caps lock completely, which might seem a bit strange, but it takes a bit of getting used to, and once you've got the hang of it, it'll be really awkward to go back to your regular size 60% keyboard, such as the one I have here, which is the AN Pro. Basically, what this allows you is just to keep your fingers in the home row, which is really, really comfortable, and you'll have to not like awkwardly reach down to the bottom corner. There's also a delete key that's been moved from the first row to the second row, right above the return key, which is also, again, one of these little tiny tweaks that they've done, just so when you're typing, you don't have to reach up super far. And this just allows you to be much more ergonomic while typing and also much more productive. I think that this layout is, when you first look at it, it might be really strange and also a bit scary because it's just so different coming from the 60% keyboards. Especially strange if you are used to the full-size keyboards or a TKL, which actually have arrow keys and a numpad. So maybe it's not the best choice if you already are used to a full-size keyboard with numpad and arrow keys. But if you use a TKL and you want something smaller because you want to put your mouse, for example, closer to your keyboard, you find it more comfortable, then looking into one of these 60% layout boards is definitely worth it. So another really special thing about this keyboard is that it's not really a mechanical keyboard, even though most people would consider it. It's using different switches than usual. So the switches used in this keyboard are Topre switches, which are, let's say, a mix between a mechanical and a membrane switch. I would say essentially you could compare them to a rubber dome switch that has a more tactile feeling and is extremely smooth. So I'll be doing a sound test in a bit and you can just listen for yourself just how smooth and nice this keyboard sounds. Thank you. These switches have to be, I think, by far my favorite switches that come straight out of the box without any modifications needed. So the typing experience on this is extremely unique because you have this really smooth keycap feel and also switch that has a really nice tactile bump. And when typing, it just gives this really, really nice sound, which is unlike any other different tactile keyboard I've tried. So I've been using MX Browns and Kyle Box Brown, and they do not compare in any way to this keyboard. The only downside that I can tell right now is that the keycaps on this unit, it might be because it's a review one, have a bit of wiggle. So every time when you would press down, it feels really good, but as soon as you are finished typing, you kind of feel the keycaps jiggling a tiny bit. Now, I would say this is not like a deal breaker, but it's also something that can be fixed. But it requires some modifications to the keyboard, which I'm not going to be doing since this is a review unit. But if you would like to find out more, I'll put some links in the description of some nice Reddit posts that also go over this and give some more insights of this. Another little downside, I think, is on the Windows configuration, you do not have any media keys. So the media keys are reserved for Mac. You can use them on Windows, but you will be then changing the layout to be the Mac version, which is a bit strange. That's just one of the tiny things that I've noticed. You'll have to replace this with a program such as Auto Hotkey. I've configured mine to be Control and then the 1, 2, 3 to be my media controls. But you can configure this to any key that you want it to be. This is just one of the little things that I've noticed that I quite liked on the AN Pro, which came with its own firmware, so you could basically map your keys to do whatever you wanted, which this only has the dip switches. But overall, I think the customization that it gives is really good. It allows you to use this on multiple systems, and while it's so light and small, I think it's excellent if you want to have one keyboard that you use on, let's say, on different computers, maybe one at home and one at work, and you have a Mac at work and a PC at home. You can easily just put this in a backpack and take it with you, flip the dip switch depending on where you're using it, and it'll be a really nice native experience on both. So for anyone that's curious about this keyboard, there's a link in the description below so you can go and check it out. I would definitely recommend it since this is like one of the most iconic keyboard designs there's available. So you might have seen this layout used on different keyboards such as the Rama M60 or a Duck Viper, which is also some really nice keyboards, but they're super hard to get. Whereas this, it's relatively pricey, but it's always available, so you can always pick one up if you like it. And if you know someone that has one, I would definitely recommend you to try one out. So I hope you all enjoyed my video and review of the HHKB Pro. Be sure to let me know in the comments below what you think of this keyboard and if you've ever tried one of these. I'd be really curious to know. And as always, make sure to hit that like button, subscribe for more videos, and follow me on my social medias, linked in the description below. See you in the next one. Bye.